the land of our fathers, the land of the lush green, the land of the poetry, the land of songs sung by male voice reaper harmony, the land of the collieries, the land of community, the land of a people ever changed by what happened at Calvary, where sin wages were settled by perfect love's poured out salary, the land of mass repentance with the posture of the bended knee, the land where pubs to pulpits to pits peaked with passion in their lungs and praise in their lips. In this land of our fathers, we stand with our forefathers from right across the ages. May a nation once again stand firm on Christ, the rock of ages. In the land of our fathers, the land of the collieries, the land of community, in the land filled with loneliness, may your church be community. Divide the division, I pray, Lord, for unity. May we speak revival, but let it start in the heart. The land of mass repentance with the posture of the bended knee. The land where pubs to pulpits to pits peaked with passion in their lungs and praise in their lips. In this land of our fathers, we stand with our forefathers from right across the ages. May a nation once again stand firm on Christ, the rock of ages. In the land of our fathers, the land of the collieries, the land of community. In the land filled with loneliness, may your church be community. Divide the division, I pray, Lord, for unity. May we speak revival, but let it start in the heart.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Jonathan Oloyede, and I want to welcome everyone that is logging on onto this platform tonight. We want to thank God for every single one of our brothers and sisters that have logged on tonight and are joining us in prayer to pray for the land, to pray for the whole of the United Kingdom and Ireland, to pray God's will and God's heart for our collective family of nations. Today, we're going to be praying for Wales, and we have one or two wonderful people that are going to be speaking from the land of Wales, speaking the heart out of the land, the burden of the land in prayer to us today. And before we do that, I want to just thank every single one of you that has logged on tonight as we focus on praying for Wales. And last week, we were able to pray for for Scotland, and we had fantastic people, leaders, and brothers and sisters from Scotland on the line, and we were praying into the issues and the prayer points that they raised concerning Scotland. The week before that, we prayed for Ireland, and we had our brothers and sisters from there come onto this platform. We prayed for Ireland, we prayed for the Republic, and as well as prayed for Northern Ireland and all the challenges that they face. So we want to just welcome every single one of you to the National Day of Prayer as we prepare to step into Easter. We're in Holy Week, and tomorrow is Easter Friday. So I would say happy Easter, a blessed Easter to every single one of you as we're on the cusp of the eve of Easter tonight. Tonight, we're going to pray. And before we do that, I want to just, I think it's Kath. Kath, are you there on the line?
I am, yes, Jonathan.
Oh, fantastic, Kath. Thank you so much for joining us. It's the Sound of Wales, right? Your group. Yes, fantastic. I know that it was going to be difficult for you to join us early, but thank God that you were able to join us on the hour. Are you able to stay for a few minutes with us?
Absolutely, yes. I'm needing to leave about 20 past, so I'm here for 20 minutes to pray for our beautiful nation.
That is fantastic. And I'm going to come back to you in a minute. I'm going to start with you, and then we're going to go into prayer. So just please hold on for a few more minutes, and I will be with you, if that's okay.
Yes.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Kath. So we're going to be praying for Wales, and I'm going to be bringing Kath on. I hear that there's actually, and she's going to tell us, there's actually a prayer chain going on for Wales as we speak. And so that is just fantastic that this evening is coinciding with the prayers that are going on over the land. The Holy Spirit is one. So Heavenly Father, we just want to thank you for tonight as we step into this hour of prayer, this moment of prayer. We pray, Heavenly Father, that you will lead and guide us as we stand in the gap to pray today and to do everything that is on your heart to do in Jesus' mighty name. And the people of God said, amen. So without much ado, because of time, I'm going to bring Kath on. And as soon as she finishes, we'll have one or two announcements to give you. If you're logging on for the very first time, we would like you to do two things for us. We'd like you to go into the chat and tell us not just where you're from, but maybe the church you represent or the community that you represent or the organization that you represent. We just want to have a feel of where people are logging in from and connecting from. And Adam is going to call out some of those locations as well as names shortly afterwards. So please, I'm going to ask you this, if you're on tonight and you can hear me clearly, we'd like you to go into the chat box, just put in your details, just a line where you're logging in from today, where you're coming from, and the organization or church that you're representing, or you're part of that community. Even if you're not a leader, even if you're just part of some local church, please tell us what your local church is, what your community is. We'd like to see and know where you are from. So Kath, let me bring you on right now. Just one second, so I can do this properly. Let me pin myself, and then I'm going to pin you. So, yes, fantastic. All right, can you hear me clearly, Kat?
I can, Jonathan.
So you seem to be in a car somewhere.
I am, funnily enough. So basically, I come from a little town called Armanford, which is near Carmarthen in Wales.
Okay.
And, we haven't seen our parents, me and my husband, since before December because of lockdown.
No,
and
wow.
Yeah, so today we live in Pontypridd, which is near Cardiff. And today we travel down to see our parents. And then I'm leading a meeting here on Zoom a bit later after this. So yeah, so I'm in West Wales, which is home. So it's lovely.
Oh, fantastic. Thank you very much for coming on, Kath. I'm told that there's some prayers going on today. Can you tell us a bit? Yeah, do you know anything about that?
Yes. So basically, amazingly, actually, there's, I don't know if you've heard of Martin Smith, who is one of the singers of Delirious, yes, and Darlene Check, who wrote My Jesus, yes, My Saviour. And just a few months ago, they got together and collaborated and prayed. And as they prayed, and it was with Chris Tomlin as well, they felt like they were writing a prayer for the nations, and it was for Australia to begin. And so they wrote this beautiful song, this beautiful, okay, prayer song, and released it in Australia. But they really felt that God was stirring in them to release this song in the mother tongues of certain nations across the world. So they felt like God was going to give them a strategy. And as they prayed, one of the first nations they felt that God was saying was our little nation of Wales, land of revival and song. Amen. And so, they contacted me and asked if I would sing it along with Mal Pope, who is another amazing, he's a wonderful man, yes, who loves the Lord. And so we did it because it's a duet. It was written by Darlene and Martin Smith. Okay. And so we did it as a duet. And I got it translated we sung it over Wales. And then I got in touch with so many church leaders across the nation and just asked if every day they would join at midday to put this song on and pray for the nation in Welsh, but it's got the English translation underneath, and it basically says, Father, remember Wales, remember your people in this land, come and heal this land of revival and song and creativity. May your people sing again. And
amen.
So it's been happening all through Lent, and there's about 101 different churches or ministries involved in every day at midday, putting that song on and using it as a means to just enter into prayer for, amen, this land of Wales.
Wow. Well, Wales is the land of song, isn't it?
It is.
Yeah, and that's why we started with worship even from the different churches from Wales. And I want you to tell us how we can pray along with you and for Wales today. And then we're going to open the floodgates. That's how we do it here. We're just going to mute ourselves on Zoom, and we're just going to pray. But before we do that, I would like you to tell us how we can pray for you and pray for the land of Wales.
Yeah, of course. I just feel like God gave this little term, and it was walls down, wells spring up. And I think we need the walls to fall down, but we need the wells to spring up, full of his living water, spirit and truth coming together. I think also we just need to pray for the economic tsunami that we are in Wales at the minute, specifically in the valleys and in the deprived areas,
yes,
that we would know God as provider, and that people in their desperation would not know where to turn, but in that not knowing, turn to God, and that there would be a harvest. I feel like the fields are white for harvest. I mean, even in our church, we've been meeting over Zoom, and we've seen more salvations over this, yes, pandemic than we've seen before. I'm part of a church that's in one of the kind of poorest areas of the Rhondda Valleys. So just praying that we would be able to, in God's strength, usher in that harvest and, amen, not get distracted by anything other than seeing his kingdom come, seeing the gospel advance in these places, that people in their desperation now, not knowing where to turn to Jesus, because, amen, he is the way, he is the truth, and he is the life. I think I just really feel, I know I am a creative, but I just feel like it's a time to call the creatives to rise up and to lead this nation into a brighter and better future.
Amen.
I feel like in Wales there's kind of two camps, and it's there's the storytellers in one side and then there's the scholars in the other side, and we've kind of kept separate. But I feel like in this season, God is wanting the storytellers and the scholars to come together to tell this good news story in an incredible way that reaches the intellectuals, that reaches the people on the margins, that reaches the broken in all sorts of different ways, you know. I think as well, we are a nation who wears our heart on our sleeves. And I feel like we need to remain humble. Jesus was a humble servant king, a servant leader. And I think we need to not pray that pride doesn't become pride and nostalgia doesn't become kind of on the top of the agenda here in Wales. But it's all about humility. Yes, recognizing what God has done in the past in this incredible nation, but recognizing that God is the God who is doing a new thing. So that is what I would say.
So we're gonna start with that. We're gonna start with walls down and wells spring up all over the land. I like that phrase. I like that prophetic statement and that prophetic word. And for us to pray over the land for God to turn around the economic tsunami, and God to bring about a salvation of souls, and for God to touch those who are the storytellers and the scholars, and for God to deal with the issue of pride if anywhere it exists, and for God to bring out humility, and for Wales to step into its calling and destiny in Jesus' name. So we're just going to pray now. I'm going to ask in a few minutes for you to round that up, either by prayer or by song. You choose. So, ladies and gentlemen, can you just unmute yourselves? And can we just pray out over Wales right now, wherever you're logging in from? We just want you to pray over Wales that the walls are going to come down and the wells are going to spring up in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The walls of the
Lord.
Walls of grace.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
The walls will come to the well, the wells will spring up.
The walls come down.
The wells will
come down.
The walls come down.
The walls come down. The walls come down. The walls
come down. The walls come down.
The walls come down. The
walls come down. The people of God said amen, and the people of God said amen. Hallelujah. You can unmute yourself, and can you pray for us now, Calf?
Dig deep, O ancient wells, befall again. We long to see our mighty God to reign, to boldly walk where ancient paths have trod, put in our land once more the fear of God. Stir it up and let it rain, your glory, God, in Wales. wheels again and stir it up. Quench our thirst and spirit come. Fall down on Wales. Lord God, we just pray that every wall in this nation would fall. Every wall of pride, every wall of religion, every wall of territorialism, every wall, Lord God, of nostalgia, that it would fall down, Lord God, that we would see that you are a God who every morning has new mercies. That, Father, we wouldn't just be, we wouldn't be devouring tin fruit, as it were, or stale bread, but that, Lord God, we would recognize that you have fresh fruit for this nation, and that you have just such a fresh bread, manna from heaven. Lord, one of the songs of this nation is bread of heaven. And Lord God, I pray that where we have become distracted, that where, Lord, we have looked to other gods, little g, other idols, Father, for our fill, that Lord God, we would know you again in this nation, Lord, in the valleys, in North Wales, in South Wales, in East Wales, in West Wales, in Mid Wales, Lord, we would know you as the bread of heaven, that Lord, where these hymns, these spiritual songs are sung in stadiums across the land by 70,000 rugby fans who don't have a clue what they're singing about, that Lord God, there would be a moment of revelation where they wouldn't just be singing to a rugby team, but Lord, they would recognize and know you as the revealed bread of heaven, the only God who would satisfy the souls of this nation. So Lord, we ask that you would rain down, that you would stir up the ancient wells, and you would do a brand new thing, to see a harvest of salvation, to see the lost saved, and to see people recognize that you alone, King Jesus, are the way, the truth, and the life. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Thank you very much, Kath, and really, really appreciate you being able to come on tonight and to pray and to tell us how to pray for Wales and to come from Wales and to speak into the prayer meeting tonight. So thank you. And we're going to release you to go and see your mom and your dad, to go and see your family that you haven't seen in a while. So thank you. And God bless you and your family, you and your husband and everybody that is with you. And thank you for leading us in prayer tonight. In Jesus' name.
God bless. Thank you so much.
God bless you, Kath. Thank you.
Bless you. Bye.
Bye. Bye for now. Bye for now. Bye for now. I'm going to be bringing on Adam. Adam, before we go into the second stage of the prayer and tonight, are you able to tell us where people have been logging on from or coming on from, if you're able to, Adam?
Yeah. I'd love to share where people are logging in from. And it's always great to be together. And although we may well be fewer in number tonight, we're certainly not fewer in terms of the places that we're logging in from. It's good to see, I think, some new people tonight. So it's good to see people from Wales, from Bangor, from Northampton, from Ludlow, from which, as Sue rightly reminds us, is just over the border from Wales. It's good to see people in Peterhead, in Bristol, in Bolton, in Brentwood, all over the United Kingdom. I was particularly glad to see tonight Hilda logging in from Biggleswade, so just down the road from me, because I'm in Bedford. So it's good to see Hilda Joy. Thank you so much for logging in tonight from Biggleswade. It's good to see people representing a range of ministries. It's good to see people representing the Neighbourhood Prayer Network, one of our partners, CLF UK, and Martin Ray, who's pastoring up there in Scotland, John Gilmore, based in Herne Hill. So all over the place this evening, and we've still got people logging in.
thank you very much, Adam. So you have two pieces of announcement for us. One is a correction of a date, and the other is a piece of announcement that we are glad to hear about.
Yes, so two bits of news for me this evening. I'm also having to dash off early this evening because having a Maundy Thursday service that I need to get to. But I'm really delighted that since we gathered on this prayer platform last week, we've seen over 5,000 people register to become part of hashtag in one accord. So the number now stands at 15,824 people saying that they're going to stand with us on Pentecost Sunday. And it's really great. One of the things that we get on a regular basis, and we're going to share more after Easter, kind of we're seeing not just individuals, but churches getting behind this. If you are an individual and you've said you want to get involved in virtual Pentecost, thank you so much for standing with us as an individual. You know, if you're an individual, I'm sure you've got more friends. Carl spoke about this last week. Tell your friends, tell five people. That's what we want to challenge you to do. Go and tell five people if you're coming on as an individual. If you're a church leader, again, it's great to see churches right across the board from a range of different streams getting involved all over the family of nations. So thank you so much to leaders that are standing with us. If you're a leader, we want you to go and tell more of your church leader friends so we can see that number rise. It's really great. I'll repeat the number again, 15,824 people in just over a month have said that they want to stand with us on virtual Pentecost and all that's happening. I've got a kind of a third announcement before I mention the update around the Leaders Day. You'll remember that last Thursday I announced that Noel Robinson has joined this team. He has joined working with us as our creative director for virtual Pentecost, and that's absolutely brilliant. Pastor Jonathan, you sat down a couple of days ago for a couple of minutes and just asked Noel to share kind of what's on his heart as we move forward for virtual Pentecost. It was in the e-news that went out last Sunday. So if you haven't seen that video, go back and watch it. But also, if you want to really hear the heart, sometimes, you know, what do they say? Things are caught, not taught. So if you want to hear about why Noel is standing with us, I recommend that video for you to go and to watch. While we've been praying this week as a team, there's been a sense by which we need to do something different around our Leaders' Day. And it's therefore, we've got a different announcement. Last Thursday, I told you that we would be doing our Leaders' Day on the 23rd of April. Well, that has now changed. So if you've got that date in the diary, scrub it out. It's not happening. What we're going to do on the eve of 1 month as we count down to virtual Pentecost, we're going to have our leaders time. So during the day, Noel Robinson will be leading us in worship. We'll have an opportunity to explain, an opportunity to interact. Yes, we're going to pray, but we're also going to allow leaders the opportunity to ask us any question they like about how it works technically, how they can get involved. And so we're going to do that during the day of Thursday, the 22nd of April. And Pastor Jonathan, when we were chatting yesterday as a team, you reminded myself and Carl that actually those that are gathering on this platform week by week, you are our ambassadors for virtual Pentecost. This isn't about Pastor Jonathan, the National Day of Prayer and Worship. It's about responding to a call that God laid upon Pastor Jonathan's heart, but other leaders all over the family of nations are standing with Pastor Jonathan in. And so as those that gather on this call and those that watch this conversation, because this goes out for those that aren't aware, those that are new this week, we put this recording out to pray both along with what we had on a Thursday evening, but also to get the updates again. This goes out on a Monday lunchtime, and it will go out again this coming Monday lunchtime at 12:30 on the NDOPW, the National Day of Prayer and Worship Facebook page, and on the Virtual Pentecost YouTube channel. But because you are our leaders and our ambassadors, there's something about saying thank you to our friends. So on the evening of Thursday, the 22nd of April at 7 o'clock. We're going to have a very special gathering where we'll do exactly what we did for leaders in the morning or during the day. We're going to do it again at night. And again, for those leaders or people that we know in your networks that can't come, but for whom you're really sensing God saying that they need to be part of this, we're going to have a very special edition of our prayer time with hopefully some worship and other things happening that evening. So put the date in your diary. And if you could do nothing for us this week, put 7 o'clock, Thursday, the 22nd of April, into your diary and encourage more people to come and to join us. It's been a really exciting week. All of that against the backdrop of getting ready for Easter. We've got some really exciting announcements. I know, Pastor Jonathan, you've been hanging around in East London this week. So we've got some great things coming up around all of our technical stuff that we'll be able to announce more of in the coming weeks. So please continue to stand with us as we prepare for virtual Pentecost on the 23rd of May this year.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Adam, for that major announcement. And that was very important that he's brought all that information. Now, I just want to just adjust what Adam has said ever so slightly. And that is that anyone that is on this call, that you lead a group, you lead a prayer group, you lead any sort of organization, anything you lead, we consider you to be leaders. And so we welcome you to the Leaders Day, the Leaders Reception on the 22nd. So those of you that cannot come in the morning at 10 a.m., please join us in the evening at 7 p.m. That's one of the main reasons why we shifted it to the Thursday, so that for those who could not make the morning 10 a.m. Leaders Reception could also make the evening Leaders Reception that we'll be having on the 22nd of April. And the reason why we're doing that is to be able to give arm all the leaders with all the information that you need for virtual Pentecost on the 23rd of May. We have some announcements we're going to be making after Easter regarding the technicals, the studio we're going to be using, the media platforms that we're going to be using. We are finalizing things behind the scenes, signing one or two contracts. So we want everybody to be involved. Now, we're just going to be rounding up in prayer in a few minutes, but I also want to invite anybody that is on this call that is from Wales, and you have a burden for us to pray for Wales, can you just please raise your digital hand wherever you are so that we can call you and ask you to say something short but sharp and specific regarding Wales. Today we are praying for Wales. And so I can see Jean is raising her literal hand, not her digital hand. So I'm going to ask Jean if you could, are you from Wales, Jean? You're muted.
I am, yes. I'm from Bangor in North Wales. I've been here 60 odd years. Yes.
Oh, wow. Jean, thank you for being on. Well, is this your first time of being on here?
I've been once before.
Oh, wow. So you're very welcome.
Yes. I'm actually preaching on the Sunday morning of Pentecost, so I can't join you that morning. I'm preaching in the Methodist Church in Bangor.
Oh, that's fine. You can always join us in the afternoon or in the evening anyway.
I'm going to join you in the afternoon.
Yes. And so, Jean, how can we pray for Wales? What is on your heart that we can pray for?
It's interesting that we were praying about clearing away the wells. That's one of the things that our prayer group have been praying, that we need to clear away the ancient wells in Wales to make the fresh water flow. It's absolutely vital that we get together. And this difference that we've got between the two languages is something that we really need to get integrated together, because it's breaking us up. We need to be united. I mean, I know we can't worship together unless we worship bilingually, but God is in all this, and we need to unite. If we don't unite, we can't shift anything. So I get quite passionate about this.
It's okay, Jean. So we want to pray into unity.
Yes.
Okay. We want to pray into unity that is authentic.
Yes.
It's real with it is. You know, and that language will not divide in yes. Jesus' name, but God will release grace to clear away the dross and yes. bring about a freshness and fresh new living water, as we've been praying before. But yes. Specifically, yes. we want to pray against every form of division.
Yes.
So yes. thank you very much, Jean. Just please stay there because I'm going to ask you to round that prayer up. But I'm going to, because you've lived in Wales for all these decades, and so you carry the heart of your nation. I'm going to ask you to pray and round that up. And so I'm going to ask everybody to unmute themselves and let's pray into unity right now across Wales. That language will not divide, that there will be no talk of division, that the living water of God will be in the
church.
Jesus' name. Amen. Jean, can you unmute yourself and can you just round up that prayer for us now, please?
Lord, thank you for the unity which we have on this platform, and that you are moving in us to bring out your plan and your purpose for this beautiful, wonderful country of ours, that we will be so united together that there will be a new revival, nothing like the old one, a new revival, that everyone will work together for the good of the community, for the good of the people, for the good of our nation. Thank you, Lord, that your heart is in it. I have a heart behind me on my banner, a heart with the cross.
Hallelujah.
That's Wales.
Amen.
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 Amen. Thank you very much, Jean. Thank you, Jean. And I am going to ask if there's one last person who wants to pray in any shape, manner, or form. This would be your chance to do that now, if you are able to pray. And if not, we're going to be rounding up. I'm just going to say one or two things and then we're going to round up. I know lots of people are preparing for Easter. And that's why we don't have as many people on the prayer line tonight. But after Easter, we're going to be gathering so much momentum and moving forward together. So does anyone still in Wales that wants us to pray anything concerning Wales? Now is the time to just raise your digital hand and we will call you. I can't see everybody, so if you're waving your hand, I can't see you. But if you raise your digital hand, so we've got Martin Ray. I'm not sure how to pronounce that.
Ray. Ray.
Martin Ray. Hi, Martin.
Hiya.
Hi.
I'm not in Wales, but I used to be in Wales in the army. But we are looking to, and God has placed Wales in my heart to do mission work and church plant in Wales. So that's why I raised my hand, because obviously for the Welsh people,
new people unmuted me.
New
usually
people.
The host unmutes you, doesn't it?
Go on, Ray.
Yeah, new people coming into Wales. So really my heart is, anyone on the Welsh platform, seek advice on that, but to pray that Wales will also receive new missionaries coming into Wales to work with them on the revival and advancement of the kingdom.
Okay, so Martin, if you don't mind me asking, how old are you?
66.
And you used to be in the army?
Yeah.
Where do you used to live in Wales?
I was in Oswestry. It's Shropshire, actually, but we did the Breckens. I did North Wales, used to sail in Barla, Snowdon. I lived in Wales over 2 years, So Penny Fan, we've done all of these places in Wales. So we did South Wales and North Wales.
Thank you very much for coming on the platform tonight and raising that prayer request, and for God to send in activists, revivalists, God to bring in people that will stand with the church, stand with local communities to bring about his agenda. That's your prayer, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so can we, for one last time, can we just unmute ourselves that God is going to raise up and God is going to send into Wales all those who he has commissioned to help the church, help communities, restoration, renewal, The people of God said, Amen. Amen. So may the Lord, there's this theme that is running through tonight, new walls, wells springing up, fresh water, new missionaries, freshness, newness, and for God to bring out living water across the whole of Wales. This is how we're going to be praying, and we're going to continue in this format. I want you to know that I think Jean from Scotland is on the line. We have people from Ireland that are on the line. We have people across England that are on the line. The people from Wales that are on the line tonight. Please, even if we're not praying particularly for your nation, let us journey together over the next 5 to 6 weeks. Let's do this 5 or 6 more times together, all the way to Pentecost, because we want to build the momentum of unity in prayer so that we're not just praying on the day. There's so much to pray. We can't pray everything on Pentecost Sunday itself, but let us journey together and let's begin to be able to hear the voices of the different regions across our family of nations and pray. And by the time we get to Pentecost, in the spirit and in prayer, we're more united than we were before. I want to ask you to own this event and make it yours. I want to thank every single one of you that has come on this platform. And we are praying and hoping that we will have people represented from every town, every city, every local area of the United Kingdom and Ireland on the platform together on that day. So if you know anyone that loves prayer, if you know any church leader, if you know any believer that can come on this platform, invite them to come and to join us in prayer. We want to continue in this spirit of prayer all the way up to Pentecost. So 5 or 6 more times, we're going to do this together. And I want to thank every single one of you for being here tonight. And despite the fact that we are almost in Easter, you've taken time out to be with us and with others in prayer tonight. And as you can hear, there's lots of new registrations that are coming through. And so I'm going to ask every single one of you before next Thursday to send that link, send the information about this prayer meeting, 5 or 10 more people that are on your contact list, invite them, bring them in, let us journey together as we go beyond Easter for the 50 days up to Pentecost. Let us begin to gather momentum, because we don't know where this is going. 15,000 people registered, that's a lot of people. And so may the Lord help us on that day as we begin to pull the technical areas together to host that number of people on one call is going to be massive. So thank you for helping. Go to the website and support this project and just ask people that can get involved, technically speaking. If you want to get involved administratively, let us know. If you want to get involved to become one of the Gideons that is supporting this this event, please go to the website and sign up to become a Gideon and just support and do whatever you can. We want to thank you for being involved today in Jesus' name. So we're going to close in this way. I'm going to ask you to unmute yourself and I'm going to put everybody on the screen and we are going to pray the Lord's Prayer together. Hallelujah. So this is time to unmute yourself and this is time to put on your cameras. This is the time to you to show your face, your handsome, wonderful, beautiful face. Hallelujah. And we're going to say the Lord's Prayer together. Amen. One, amen. Two, three, go.
Amen.
Thank you, everyone. Have a fantastic Easter. Have a fantastic weekend. And we'll see you next Thursday at 7 p.m. with your five friends. God bless you and see you. To David Legg, good to see you, David. Good to see you. Thank you.
Bye.
Thank you, Jean. Thank you, everyone that's joined us. Thank you for being here tonight. Thank you, everyone. Thank you. Thank you. God bless you.
Alan
Shepard, thank you. Thank you, Joanne, Colin. Thank you, Elizabeth, Meg. Thank you very much, Wendy. Thank you, Anne. Thank you, Catherine, Patricia.
God bless you.
David Connolly. Thank you. Hallelujah.
Bless Hallelujah. You. Patricia, Amen.
Paula, Amen. Moses, Christine. God bless you. Have a wonderful weekend. Bye.
Bye.
God bless you. Bye.
Bye.